In this video, we'll cover one of the two major portions of the Aero app where you'll spend most of your time, the airport information tab. This video does assume that you've already gone through the general overview or have a good knowledge of how to use the Aero app or applications like it. So let's jump right into the airport information tab. You see here that we have the airport information tab highlighted, and we're on the info page, and everything underneath this submenu is going to relate all to KMKL. And that's McKellar Sipes. So first off, to get to a specific airport or information that you need to pull up, you're going to use this search function that's shown here in the top left. It's going to pull up your search information. Now notice you can do any identifier for whatever you're looking up. And if you see here in the gray, it's going to show the list of searches that I've done. And usually it goes with the last five searches that you've put in there. So you can quick search any of those. So let's use the search function here. And if you notice at the bottom, you have ICAO, name, and distance. And what that's going to do is that's going to filter out the search results in order. So if I filter out ICAO, it's going to give me the alphabetically on the ICAO name. If I search by name, it's going to give me alphabetically by the actual name. And if I go by distance, it's going to show me the closest stuff to me. So let's take a look at, let's go KBNA for Nashville. Well, there's KBNA for Nashville, and it shows up automatically. Let's take any K, and you can look, see there I have K, and it's going to go all in order. If I take maybe Albuquerque and just go KAB, here's everything that has KAB in the ICAO name, and I can click name, and it's going to take it by specific name of the area, like Aberdeen or Abilene. And if I take it by distance, it's going to get me the closest thing that's KAB. Now if I drop a Q in there, Albuquerque is the closest thing that I have to me that meets that ICAO name, so it's only gonna have the one. And while we're in here, let me show you too, if you wanna favorite something, all you gotta do is click on this star, and that could be one of your favorite locations or one of your favorite searches that you do. So if you wanted to enter a favorite, all you gotta do is click over here onto your favorite star, and it's gonna show you all of your favorite airports that you have. So if you have a group of them that you want to keep in that favorites, maybe it's your local area, you can put that in there. Instead of search, you can click the star and pull up your favorite areas. So let's click on Nashville. So you notice when we click on Nashville, it now puts it up in the top of left of the airport information box. And now everything below here for the supplemental information is going to be specific to the Nashville International Airport. So the first tab we see that we come up to is the info. And this is actually a great tab. You'll spend most of your time on this page because it's almost like a raw conversion into a readable version of the METAR. It gives you everything broke down into easy readable language, and it gives you access to all of the pertinent data. So you see here we have general info, all of the communications, radios, all of the runways, even down to what kind of runways they've got, what the actual heading is, lat longs, and it breaks it down for all of those runways, and then it gives you any remarks, much like an airport facility directory does. Now, once you're at the top, what's great about here is you can just click on the airport diagram if you'd like to see an airport diagram, and it's gonna make that full screen. So you have access to your whole airport diagram with every bit of information that you would need, and then you can close back out of that. It also gives you chart supplement. If you click chart supplement, that's gonna give you the airport facility directories supplement for the Nashville Airport. So you can look here and you can see that the Nashville International Airport has all the information just like you would read from the airport facilities directory. And when you're done with that, just go back to info and it will take you back. So last but not least, we have the giant report, which is basically a huge version and a report of all of this information that in this case Nashville has. It's done by the Air Force generally, and it has more information than you might ever need to know. And it's a quick breakdown of every piece of equipment that's used in suitable field and landing areas and whether or not certain aircraft can run on it. And it's a great piece of information for certain airfields. Now let's move on to some of the other tabs here. If you go over to the next from info, APD, which is your airport diagram, that's gonna give you the airport diagram, same as you would out of that last info page on the little pop out for the thumbnail. Now keep in mind as well, if you look just below the airport diagram here at the gray bars, you're gonna see these gray bars in every single supplemental category. And sometimes they do things, sometimes they don't. But just by clicking on this, it gives me an option for a drop-down menu, and you can see that I have a hotspot diagram, and that's going to give me information for what each of those hotspots are and what they are there for. Or you can just slide left and right to see if there's more information, and it will tell you that. Next over, we've got the instrument approach charts. Same with this, the instrument approach charts are all slidable from left to right. And you can click on your gray bar for information on which you want. You could even separate them based on what type of approach you want. If you just want to see the ILSs, you can see just the ILSs. If you want to see just the GPS or the RNAV, it's that way as well. So let's pick an approach here for ILS. So here we have ILS 402 Center in Nashville, and you can see the green circle. What that green circle means is that this is geo-referenced. And so if we were flying out in this approach, you would see our little airplane move around on the approach plate. So if we move over to departure procedures, it is the same thing. Notice departure procedures. We have all of our departure procedures listed here. If I click into the gray box, and if we pick one, it has information both with departure procedure and the definitions and design in writing. These are not geo-referenced at this point, but they hopefully will be in future updates. Now let's jump over to our arrival procedures. Same idea. All of our arrival procedures are in the gray box, and or I could just swipe left and right to get to any arrival procedure that I want. Next is our takeoff minimums. Same thing that you'd be looking up in a flip chart if you wanted to go find your takeoff minimums for that area, or you could use the gray bar as well. Landing minimums are the same. It has all the information there for the landing minimums, that just like you would with the alternate minimums inside your flip chart. Other is going to be any other types of charts that are available. Host nation is going to be based on what host nation data that you load up as part of your data load for international areas, maybe a JEP chart or something that's specific to that area. You can jump over here to weather and look in the METARs and TAFs. Since I'm hooked up to the internet, or if you're using your cellular data, you can have the METAR here and it tells you where it comes from. You can also decode that METAR and it gives you a nice decoded view of the weather at Nashville Airport. And if you look at the NOTAMs, it will also take you to the DINs. It will give you all the NOTAMs for the location that you are going to. And you can see here at the bottom, we've actually created, based on this, another set of toolbars at the very bottom based on an ADS-B receiver or internet. So you could say, hey, I wanted to get the METAR from the ADS-B receiver, or I can walk through any of these if I have ADS-B that allows me to get any of that information while in flight. So that concludes the section on airport information, and move on to some of the other videos in the set to get a more detailed explanation of each tab.